spin me around. People get used to and bookmark sites like VidMe, VID.me, VidMe. Bookmark that site, folks, because YouTube may soon go completely vanilla on you.
Facts, 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 facts.
The USS Carl Vinson Carrier Battle Group is entering Korean waters as the tension generated by North Korean threats of nuclear war and the growing defiance of the U.S. Commander-in-Chief, President Donald Trump, and the international community reaches a heightened level.
Ultimately, I believe that we are going to get rid of most of those problems, and there won't be fear of anybody. That's the way it should be. We have a very big problem in North Korea, and as I said, I really think that China is going to try very hard and has already started. A lot of the coal boats have already been turned back. You saw that yesterday and today. They've been turned back. The vast amount of coal that comes out of North Korea going to China, they've turned back the boats. That's a big step, and they have many other steps that I know about. So we'll see what happens. It may be effective. It may not be effective. It's not effective. We will be effective. I can promise you that.
As of March 16, 2017, the deployment of the Terminal High Altitude Area Defense Anti-Ballistic Missile Systems, or THAAD, capable of intercepting short, medium, and intermediate-range ballistic missiles with hypersonic infrared accuracy as the missile's flight path reaches a termination phase, have been underway between South Korean officials and U.S. military, regardless of condemnation by the Chinese government and South Korean protest groups. However, President Donald Trump's highly successful show of diplomacy after meeting with Chinese President Xi Jinping has signaled an agreement for the two countries to work together to denuclearize North Korea. Business Insider writes, Xi was quoted as saying, China insists on realizing the denuclearization of the peninsula and is willing to maintain communication and coordination with the American side over the issue on the peninsula. China has deployed 150,000 extra troops to the North Korean border. Meanwhile, there is speculation that Kim Jong-un will likely go into hiding, just as his father did during the Iraq War, for 6 weeks. Regardless, the North Korean state news outlet Rodong Sinmun defiantly stated, the South Korean puppet warmongers' war drills targeting the North are very risky provocations, little short of setting fire on an arsenal. A touch-and-go situation is prevailing due to the hideous provocations of the U.S. and the South Korean puppet group of traitors, spurring the execution of the special operation targeting the supreme leadership of the DPRK while staging the largest ever North-targeted joint military drills. The DPRK is sure of its final victory in its showdown with the U.S. The Korean War in the 20th century brought about the beginning of a downhill turn for the U.S., but the one in the 21st century will end in the final doom of the U.S. The foolhardy maneuvers of the puppet forces are reminiscent of a puppy knowing no fear of the tiger. Again, that from Rodong Sinmun, the North Korean state news outlet. An annual report of North Korea's military capabilities by the U.S. Department of Defense, released in early 2014, identified the North Korean's army strength at 950,000 personnel, 4,200 tanks, 2,200 armored vehicles, 8,600 artillery guns, and over 4,800 multiple rocket launchers. Reuters reports foreign journalists visiting North Korea have been told to prepare for a big and important event on Thursday. Although there were no indications it was directly linked to tensions in the region over the isolated state's nuclear weapons program. Around 200 foreign journalists are in Pyongyang as the country marks the 105th birth anniversary of its founding president, Kim Il-sung, on April 15th, North Korea's biggest national day known as the Day of the Sun. John Bound for Infowars.com.
It shows you just how radically things are spinning out of control for the power elite. They panicked when Trump got elected. They're scrambling to try to reconsolidate power. They're attempting to set up a shadow government. They're doing their very best to torpedo the alternative media. They're doing their very best to vilify the entire Trump cabinet, especially people like Steve Bannon, where they're in an out-and-out war against the entire Patriot movement, against the bedrock culture of this country, and they don't care what they have to do to, it's one of those ends justify the means.